Sure you don't know what this is about?
No idea. Where's Angela?
Mr. Stilver, court is on the record. I have received your motion to dismiss. Call your first witness.
Thank you, Your Honor. The defense would like to call AUSA Angela Valdez to the stand.
Your Honor, we have to strongly object. You can't allow AUSA Valdez to testify. She's the prosecutor on this case.
Your Honor, AUSA Valdez is going to testify to a repeated pattern of prosecutorial misconduct throughout this case due to institutional bias against Mr. St. Patrick. I'd say as a prosecutor on the case, she is uniquely qualified to provide testimony as a material witness.
Well, I'd like to hear what she has to say.
Swear to tell the truth and nothing but the truth will help you, God?
I do.
The court already knows about the prosecution's failure to present knowledge of the traffic stop between Agent Knox and Mr. St. Patrick. Apparently now there's a surveillance video that's exculpatory for my client.
The surveillance footage from Truth Nightclub from the night of Greg's murder until the arrest of Mr. St. Patrick doesn't show him or anyone else placing the murder weapon in the location that it was found. It is clearly exculpatory.
Clearly. And to whom did you report this information about the surveillance video?
Mike Sandoval.
And how did Mr. Sandoval respond?
That he wasn't going to turn the tapes over to you because it shone a bad light on the prosecution. I also reported doubts about Mr. St. Patrick's guilt to John Mock, who in turn ensured that I was formally kept out of strategy on the case.
Do you now believe that my client is innocent of killing Agent Knox?
Yes, I do. I was wrong. I have to do what I can to make things right.
Even if it means facing suspension or termination?
Yes.
No further questions, Your Honor.
So, Ms. Valdez, you're testifying to prosecutorial misconduct. I'm just curious why you're not including yourself on that list.
I violated no Brady rules while working this case.
Yeah, I'm not talking about this case. I'm talking about your personal relationship with the defendant, your sexual relationship, and how it led to him stealing evidence from your home and afforded him access to classified information about Felipe Lobos, including the fact that he was still alive.
Ms. Valdez, is all this true? Ms. Valdez, I asked you a question.
It's true, Your Honor.
Your Honor, AUSA Cooper Sachs has just brought to my attention that after speaking to the CSI tech that coded Mr. St. Patrick's fingerprints, it appears that Ms. Valdez admitted those into evidence 24 hours later than he originally stated in his report.
Your Honor, I can't deny what
you're saying. I've heard enough. The allegations suggested today are the most egregious that I have ever heard. Your blatant disregard for the oath you took as an officer of the court is appalling.
Thank you, Your Honor.
I am not finished, Mr. Mock. You and Mr. Sandoval, you stand there pointing your finger at Ms. Valdez, you fail to acknowledge that all of these lapses in judgment happened on your watch. Is what she said true?
Your Honor, it is.
Mr. Silver, the prosecution's willful misconduct was improper and conducted in bad faith. I see no alternative but to dismiss the charges against the defendant. Mr. Mock, Mr. Sandoval, I will be recommending to Maine Justice that all of the members of this prosecution be suspended pending an investigation. Mr. St. Patrick.
Your Honor.
You will be processed out of the system with this court's apologies. If you are guilty of this or any other crime, I hope a more professional prosecution team will bring you to justice in the future. For now, sir, you can go home.
Thank you, Angela.
Don't thank me, Jamie. You didn't do